Good afternoon and welcome to the 2020 PADS Gala. Sorry? What? We're celebrating grad, not gala? Are you serious? Well, this dress is a bit much then, don't you think? Oh my gosh, this is live? This is so embarrassing. One moment, please. Good afternoon and welcome to the 2020 PADS graduation. Welcome friends, supporters, PADS volunteers, staff, board, and most importantly, clients and graduates. This is a different kind of year and a different kind of grad. How could we not celebrate this year's amazing graduates and 33 years of changing lives, one PADS dog at a time? My name is Kim Gramlich and I will be your MC for our 2020 PADS graduation ceremony. I'm a director on the PADS board and also a PADS client. I'm here with my sidekick, PADS 2019 graduate, accredited facility dog Puma. Those that are wondering about her predecessor Kaber can rest assured that like you, he is at home watching this live surrounded by bananas. I'm sad to say that this year, I don't get the privilege of seeing all of your smiling faces, hearing your cheers and snapping a selfie of Puma with all of you in the audience. Instead, I ask you to snap a quick picture or a short video yourself and post it in the comments or tag us in your stories, and Katie will share it out for all to see. Please tag hashtag PADSGrad, and if you're cheering a particular team, you can tag hashtag team PADS and then the dog's name. So for example, PADS Heroes Village could tag their story hashtag team PADS Hero. This way, all our graduates can see all the excitement online simply by clicking on those links. And did everything I just say sound super complicated? Then just tell us in the comments where you're watching from and who you are cheering for, and we will gladly make sure that they get to see your pictures. Last year, I announced that we were graduating a record-breaking 26 dogs. The plan had been to graduate even more this year, and then this little thing called COVID happened. When the world came to a crashing halt, I'm not sure any of us expected to graduate any dogs, but our extraordinary team, including many of those watching, managed to hole up with your dogs, get creative, learn in unfamiliar ways, and train these dogs in unprecedented virtual ways. And what about our graduates, some of whom are new to the dog world? We've heard some of our graduates' creative stories, like clicking and treating spouses to practice this before the dog arrived, meeting dogs for the first time via Zoom, and even giving dogs cues on Zoom. And our dogs are all so amazing that they did it. We know that virtual training and meeting your dog online is a little sad in comparison to that dynamic moment when a client walks into team training for the first time. But we can assure you that that moment when the dog finally arrived was still mighty sweet. I think the anticipation might have been even greater. Imagine for a second when the graduates you will meet tonight finally got to take the leash for the first time. One word, special. So with that, today we are celebrating the graduation of 22 PADS dogs and the placement of 9 very important pets or VIPs. Today you will see service dogs, hearing dogs, accredited facility dogs, and our newest breeding dogs on the screen. Each of our grads were sent their very own graduation package in the mail, but we want to thank the people that made this possible. Kathy for sewing each graduate's 2020 bandana. Matthew for personalizing them, and Nola for beautifully packing and shipping all these boxes. A huge thank you to Jeff of Vancouver Dog Photography for his incredible talent and the time he took filming much of our grad presentation content. Big Dog Little Dog Bakery for their delicious treats, as usual. Cactus Club Cafe for their donation of gift cards so each grad is able to celebrate with someone special. Our amazing supporter Carla that made and provided adorable holiday ornaments for each graduate. Finally, a huge thank you to YVR for providing us this wonderful location to film in, and Gear Base Camera Rentals for the audio-video recording that's making this possible. And with that, please join me in welcoming our PADS training program staff to introduce our graduates.
Welcome to the client graduate section of our ceremony. We are really excited to present our 16 graduating teams today. Connection and relationship are at the heart of everything we do at PADS. Our relationships with our dogs help us to connect with each other and with our communities every day. We are learning to connect in new and unexpected ways during this pandemic. Remarkable is the word that comes to my mind about what we have accomplished this year. 15 of the 16 teams graduating this year started and completed team training during the pandemic. We were in the middle of team training with 6 clients when the COVID-19 numbers began to rise and the provincial restrictions were put in place. We continued team training using online video conferencing. That was a quick and steep learning curve. Our amazing clients were enthusiastic, patient, and flexible with all the changes. As the spring and summer events unfolded, we kept evolving as well. We continued with advanced training of dogs in all of our campus locations. Rob in Nanaimo, Jessica and Ashley in Burnaby, Lisa in Chilliwack, Dana in Mission, and Miranda in Calgary. Thank you to this amazing team of people. We continued to make matches with dogs and clients and to complete team training for service, hearing, and accredited facility dog clients using online video conferencing and then with physical distancing outside. Throughout this year, we have accomplished so much. To the many people who have helped us by volunteering their time, from breeder caretakers, raisers and sitters, to the volunteers who helped with facilities and grounds maintenance, thank you so much. We appreciate all of your help. A French philosopher said many years ago, "Let's gladden the hearts of those who travel the way with us. Be swift to love and make haste to be kind."
With his long, soft ears, soulful expression, and gentle nature, Hero has affectionately been known throughout puppy raising and advanced training as Eeyore. His neutral face and his ecstatic face are basically the same, except for the twinkle in his eye. Hero's affinity for people, and in particular children, made him a natural choice for an accredited facility dog position in a school. When he's not at work, Hero loves heading into the woods with Lindsay, as they both love to decompress in nature.
My name is Lindsay Hill, and I'm an educator in the Coquitlam School District. I have the honor to be partnered with accredited facility dog Hero, a 3-year-old black lab. Hero is my second AFD. Just like my first PADS dog, Orion, Hero has a huge positive impact on so many students. There is certainly more and more sound empirical research surfacing that supports what I see every day. These amazing dogs can help so many students navigate challenging emotions and behaviors that not only impact their learning, but their overall well-being. Hero helps students feel calm and relaxed, as well as brings pure joy simply with his presence. I am so grateful to PADS, the organization, Margaret, Dana, Ron, and all the staff, as well as all the wonderful volunteers like Karen who helped shape his journey. A special thank you to Heather, his first human mom, who loved him unconditionally and raised this lovely and lovable guy. I am so excited to see what the future holds for Hero and I in the world of education.
Congratulations, Team Hero.
For the Star Wars fans, you will understand what I mean when I say that young Kylo took after his namesake, Kylo Ren. When he initially started in advanced training, there were questions about whether or not Kylo actually wanted to be a working dog. It very quickly became apparent that there was a gem of a dog just waiting to find his perfect match. I think Kylo always knew that he wanted to be a PTSD service dog with his incredible affinity for connecting deeply with one individual. Before he had bed privileges, Kylo would fall asleep sitting up so that he could still be touching you. He picked up his PTSD tasks very quickly and throwing in his own unique twist when he was sure that he knew better than I did what the right thing was to do. What a wonderful coincidence that his new person is also a big Star Wars fan.
Kylo, as a lot of you know, or if you don't know, is he's for a post-traumatic stress disorder. I don't keep it a secret that I have post-traumatic stress disorder and I've struggled with it for years. I used to be a paramedic. I tried everything before. I had therapists and psychologists and a whole team of people who were trying to keep me together and put me together, and it helped a bit, but nothing really got me past the point of being able to go out and do things without anxiety and panic attacks and springs from depression, like cascading chaos of what that is. And then I got Kylo. And Kylo, I've had him since the end of February, is magic. It's made my life a million times better. I don't really have panic attacks so often. I don't have anxiety so often. And if you don't know, PTSD is a really isolating illness. So I struggled, I lost relationships, lost friends, family, didn't know how to relate to me. And you're lonely. And then that's like also the added bonus of having Kylo come into my life, because he makes it magic. And I just want to thank all of you so much for making my life a million times better. Thank you.
Congratulations, Team Kylo.
Bright and Stormy are the perfect match. They are both lady bosses who let nothing hold them back. Bright is a sweet but spicy girl who loves to work hard and play harder. As Stormy's first service dog, Bright goes with her everywhere. She picks up items, provides balance for trips to the beach, open doors, and carries the shopping, all without knocking over any of the breakable items at the ceramic shop where Stormy works. When they aren't conquering the world, these two can be found spending time with friends and enjoying many of the local parks and beaches that Victoria has to offer.
Hi everyone, my name is Stormy, and this year in 2020, I was matched with Pads Bright.
Bright has become my best friend so quickly, and I feel like we just get closer and closer every time she helps me out. She's overall made my life so much easier to get around, with so many less worries about my physical limits, by always being there to do tasks for me quickly and much more easily than if I were to try. When I first brought Bright home, I was probably more stressed and nervous about the change than she was. But we got used to each other pretty quickly, and once I knew that my snooty cat Nikita was tolerating her well, that everything was meant to be. Now, Bright and Nikita sit side by side outside the kitchen in the mornings to watch my mom cook or make coffee. I work in a paint-your-own ceramic studio, and having Bright around to help me and keep me company while I work mainly from home during the pandemic has been really great. We walk to the studio once or twice a week, and sometimes we'll drive over without my wheelchair for some small tasks at work that need to get done. Bright has been learning how to support my walking these past few months, and it's been going really well. She can help me walk around the house and the studio by supporting some of my weight while we walk side by side. We've even been able to go down onto the beaches together, which we both really enjoy. It all takes a lot of self-control for Bright, too. She loves the beach and the water, so it's been a great activity for us to do together. It's been amazing to watch Bright learn how to help pull me through the soft sand and up onto some taller rocks. We both look forward to seeing what Pads is up to, and we love seeing others get matched with such life-changing sidekicks.
Congratulations, Team Bright!
Truffle is the sweetest companion and always happy to get out and about. We had the opportunity to have two training adventures together, one to Calgary and one to an annual courthouse dog convention in Seattle. She dazzled everyone and was so well behaved. Just the sight of Truffle melts hearts. Jordan was matched with service dog Truffle, and they live in the lower mainland. Together, they enjoy hiking, camping, stand-up paddleboarding on lakes. Congratulations, Team Truffle and Jordan.
My name is Jordan and my service dog is Truffle. Truffle is such a sweet and quietly engaging dog on first glance, both to me and to people she meets. She's a subtle dog at first. She comes across as a bit of a princess. She does love her creature comforts, and she also enjoys working and playing hard. The more I get to know Truffle, the more I am learning about all the different sides of her personality. She's a really fast runner. On the off-leash trail, she loves to sprint as fast as her legs will go, and at the dog park playing with other dogs, none are faster. I've been working with Truffle since March 2020, and during the summer and fall, we have done a lot of camping, hiking, and stand-up paddling. As the weather's been getting colder, I purchased her a special camping bed, which she really enjoys. She sat on us with it in the front yard on Halloween night while we sat around the propane fire and watched the trick-or-treaters come by for treats. I first learned about pads in 2019, and I was very excited once I found out I had been matched with Truffle in 2020. She's the perfect mix for me. She gets along with everyone we cross paths with, humans and creatures alike. At home, Truffle and one of the cats, Ash, love to play with a tennis ball. Over the last couple of months, I have watched them grow more and more comfortable with each other, and they are at a point now where they both understand that they have similar interests, playing with the ball, but they can't quite figure out how to navigate their friendship to its fullest potential. Their interactions entertain me every day, and I look forward to the moment they finally figure out how to play pass with the ball together. It seems like they look forward to it too. Thank you to all of Truffle's puppy raisers and sitters, her advanced trainers, and her sponsors. Your hard work with training Truffle has paid off. She has wonderful behavior when we're running errands, and she's equally awesome when we're hiking and camping or at home. Everywhere we go, people are enamored with her and how well behaved she is. At work, the most common comment was, "Oh, there's a dog. I didn't even realize she was there," because her behavior was so exceptional. Thank you very much to all of the PADS community. Your gift of time and commitment to her training has made an incredible difference to me. Her presence in my life has provided so much support. I really appreciate it.
Congratulations, Team Truffle and Jordan.
David lives in Airdrie, Alberta with his wife, Leah. Burke is David's first service dog. Burke is a big, goofy, easygoing guy whose loves in life include napping and mealtimes, but not necessarily in that order. David and Burke worked through a virtual team training through the spring and summer of this year and have hit the ground running, including many work trips and even a fishing trip in northern Saskatchewan. During their downtime, Burke and David enjoy leisurely strolls at an often painfully slow Burke speed, hitting the gym and spending time with family.
Hi, my name is David Dominey. I was an RCMP member for 28 years, and my service dog is Burke. Burke is an amazing dog with many different sides to his personality. When we're at home, he follows me everywhere around the house, and he is playful and yet relaxed. Actually, for most of you who know Burke, he's probably more relaxed than playful. Burke goes everywhere with me. Burke goes to work on errands, and Burke accompanies me when I travel for work to different communities. Burke has become very well known at a lot of hotels in the Edson, Valmont, Kamloops area. I met Burke 9 months ago, and in a very short period of time, Burke has had a profound impact on my life, so I thank you very much. I first learned about PADS in 2019, and in 2020, I took team training and was probably one of the first people to go through team training in the COVID-19 era. I would be remiss if I didn't thank a whole bunch of people, to the organizers, volunteers, and PADS in general, but specifically to some of the sitters, Elaine and Wendy, raisers, and an advanced sitter of Carmen, advanced sitter Sydney, raisers Madeline and Troy and Kyle, and Wilson Tree Service, who is advanced trainer sponsor. I appreciate that very much. The two people that I would like to thank the most, though, are Margaret Hicks and Miranda. Without you guys, I could not have done this. I appreciate your patience. And if you can get me through team training, you can get anyone through. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Team Burke.
Quixley is Eli's first assistance dog. Eli lives in the Greater Vancouver area. Quixley is a handsome yellow lab golden retriever mix. He has a friendly and cuddly personality and loves to spend quality time with his person. He is a very loyal dog. One of Quixley's favorite things to do is pick up his toys and bring them to Eli one at a time. Eli and Quixley love to spend time together outdoors, going for walks on nearby trails and in the neighborhood.
Hi, everyone. everyone. I'm Quixley, and I'm going to show you a day in my life as a PADS assistance dog. I live with my new best friend, Eli. He is originally from Israel. This is very cool because we developed secret codes in Hebrew that other dogs and people don't understand. But don't worry, we don't got them. Kelev Tov! Every morning, I start with the Happy to be Alive Wiggle Butt Dance. Some of you may be familiar. Then I have my breakfast, drink, and go back to snooze and digest. Our workday starts at 8 a.m. Eli is working on his PhD at SFU, so sometimes we go to the laboratory on campus, but most of the time we go to the home office because of the Rona. I let Eli do his teaching and researching, but sometimes I interrupt and nudge like I was taught to. It is important that I keep him on schedule and that he gets out for some exercise and fresh air, so at 10 a.m. I put on my uniform and we go for our first walk. After this walk, I settle into my spot for more observations while Eli is working, until our second walk at 2 p.m. After our second walk, it is time to take Eli to the gym because he needs more exercise than me. At the gym, I am his spotter and make sure to stay put and always look at Eli, unless I'm snoozing, but shh. When we get home from the gym, Eli spoils me with grooming and playing, and right after I take off my superhero cape and do my happy to be off the clock dance. At 4 p.m., it's my favorite part of the day, dinner. After dinner, I'm pretty snoozy, but we really like to watch baseball or the Nature Channel. I try to get as much cuddles and couch time as I can until around 9:30 when it is time to get Eli ready for bed. My pre-bed routine is to brush my teeth and to pee outside. Then I go back to my bedroom bed. Yes, I have two beds. And Eli tucks me in. I spend most of the night dreaming of playing with other dogs and eating yummy foods. Thanks for checking in with me.
Congratulations, Team Quixley.
Kristen lives in Calgary, Alberta with her partner, Martin. She has been matched with Handsome Hammond as her first service dog. Hammond has a charming combination of sensitive soul and put-me-in-coach attitude. Kristen and Hammond completed team training in the spring of 2020 as one of our first ever virtual team training participants. Hammond performs many tasks for Kristen, such as retrieving dropped items, carrying the shopping with aplomb, opening and closing doors, and tapping the key fob to let Kristen into the apartment. This team can often be found in the local off-leash area or visiting with friends and family.
Hammond has already made such a huge impact on my life. He assists me with my physical limitations and day-to-day tasks, like picking things up if I drop them, pushing door buttons, and even opening the heavy door of my condo. And even beyond that, he's my new best friend and constant companion. He motivates me and gives me the confidence to be more active and get outside. He keeps me company and he brings a smile to my face every single day with his sweet nature and enthusiasm for helping. I look forward to many more adventures with him, and I want to thank all of the PADS staff and volunteers whose lives he's touched for all the hard work and sacrifice that went into getting him where he is today, and for letting him make such a huge difference in my life.
Congratulations, Team Hammond.
Cirque is Brooke and Daphne's first accredited facility dog. Brooke and Daphne live and work in the Okanagan area. Brooke is Cirque's primary handler and works in child advocacy, and Daphne is Cirque's secondary handler and works as a women's counselor. Cirque is a lovely yellow Labrador who loves to meet new people and is always keen for a cuddle session. When not working, Brooke loves to go camping and hiking with Cirque. On the days when Cirque is with Daphne, they love to go on outdoor adventures together, like swimming and walking on local trails.
Cirque was placed as an accredited facility dog in May of 2020. Her new workplace is Oak Child and Youth Advocacy Center. She has two handlers and two homes. Cirque lives part-time with Daphne and her husband near the lake, where she enjoys swimming, boating, paddling, and her cat, Brother Beckham. She also lives part-time at Brooks with her husband, two wee humans, and Sadie, the silly doodle. Cirque enjoys going to the beach, jumping off the dock, and racing the kids to shore, along with endless games of tug and chase. Cirque's job at the Oak Center is to support children and youth who have experienced abuse. She provides a comforting presence during meetings with professionals and is starting accompanying her clients to court. when not working at the Oak Center, CIRC works with the Stopping the Violence Counseling Program with women who have experienced domestic and sexual violence. She brings compassion and patience to her work and provides an exceptional amount of comfort during difficult counseling sessions. CIRC excels at her job due to her gentle demeanor and love for kids. Team CIRC thanks the sponsors, raisers, sitters, trainers, and everyone at PADS for their amazing work.
Congratulations, Team CIRC! Rainbow is Sari's second accredited facility dog. Sari works and lives on Vancouver Island. Rainbow is an adorable yellow lab who is quite goofy and loves to make people smile. She loves to get lots of pets and spend cuddle time with people to brighten their day. Sari works with children doing neuropsychological assessments. Having a dog named Rainbow is a great way to engage with children when they first arrive at the assessment center. When not working, Sari and Rainbow love to go to the beach and go for walks on trails and in the neighborhood.
I am thrilled to be participating in a celebration of Rainbow and all the other amazing PADS dogs who are graduating today. Rainbow has been working with me for just about 3 months. She works alongside of me at Queen Alexandra Center, supporting children with neurological and neurodevelopmental challenges who are coming to see me for assessment. It is a stressful experience for children, and many are quite worried about the testing we will do. But then they meet Rainbow, with her soulful eyes and wagging tail and goofy personality, and everything seems a bit easier for them. Thank you so much to everyone who has had a piece of helping Rainbow become the sweet, loving, silly dog that she is. As a former puppy raiser myself, I want to extend a special thank you to Sandra, Gwyn, and Cameron. I know how much work it takes to bring a small, little puppy into your life and nurture them and love them. Help them grow the skills and confidence they need to be a working dog, and then hand them over to advanced trainers. Thank you for giving your heart and energy to help Rainbow be who she is. I really hope that we have a chance to meet someday. And thank you to Ashley, Margaret, and the training team at PADS for helping Rainbow shine as an AFD, and her advanced sitters Nicola and Susie. And thank you to Shirley Stanley for being Rainbow's puppy sponsor, and to TELUS Victoria Community Board for being the team sponsor. It really does take a village, and PADS is the best kind of village there is. Congratulations to Rainbow on her graduation. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Team Rainbow.
Congratulations, Team Rainbow. Sassafras is Stephanie's first hearing dog. Stephanie lives in central Alberta with her husband Timothy and a hedgehog named Trixie. They are getting ready to meet their newest bundle of joy in January 2021. Sassafras is a lovely black lab with a quirky side. Sassafras alerts Stephanie to many sounds, including the doorbell, phone, her name being called, and the smoke alarm. In her downtime, Sassafras loves to sit on the front porch and watch over their neighborhood. Sassafras was excited for the snowfall in October and spent hours playing in the yard with the fresh snow.
Spontaneous deafness at the age of 21 took a lot from me, and I didn't understand how I could be the same person again. Scared to leave my house or do anything out in society is a hard thing to get over. Receiving Sassafras to be my ears has made all the difference in my life. Through Sassafras, PADS has given me back my independence and freedom to be who I am, without the fear or danger. I feel so much more safe in my own home, knowing that she will alert me if there is an alarm going off, especially with a baby on the way. PADS has given me back my identity with Sassafras, and I couldn't be more grateful.
Congratulations, Team Sassafras.
Summer is a beautiful black Labrador retriever. She is cheerful, energetic, and affectionate. All traits that are perfect in her role as an accredited facility dog at a school. Summer's first placement was as a service dog. In her new role, John and Summer use some of those skills, like opening doors and retrieving objects, in order to provide educational opportunities for students and staff about assistance dogs. Her most important task, though, is to provide a warm and welcoming presence for all the children at school. John says she brings such joy and comfort to everyone.
I'm John Vanderleek. I'm principal at Langley Christian Elementary School, preschool to grade 5 campus. And this is PAD Summer 2. Honored to have her as part of my team. We're really excited to have her at the school, especially during kind of some times that can be a little stressful with COVID and all. Summer has just been welcomed by kids, and she's welcomed students too. So she's made this place really special, and we're really thankful for PADS, the sponsors, the puppy sitters, and the puppy raisers. And we just are excited about the work she's doing here. We want to thank everyone for your support.
Congratulations to Team Summer.
Sunny is Mark's first assistance dog. Mark lives in the Greater Vancouver area. Sunny is a handsome yellow Labrador whose name suits him perfectly. He is a friendly boy who would brighten anyone's day. Mark and Sunny love to go walking together every day. Mark does a daily obedience routine with Sunny in many different locations, including at the trails, at home, and his neighborhood. Sunny is a rock star with his durations of 3 minute stand, 5 minute sit, and 20 minute down.
Hello, my name is Mark Clint, and I was matched with Sunny in September, and we've been working really hard on our team training. I wanted to take a second and introduce myself to you. So in doing so, I hope it will allow you to better appreciate the incredible value of this gift, the overwhelming appreciation I have for all the Team Sunny spirit, your dedication, your sacrifices, your commitments to raising and training him, and then handing him over to a total stranger. No doubt that's a very difficult task. I think I can appreciate that. I am a Vietnam veteran with over 1,000 hours of flight time as a crew chief and a gunner in a Huey gunship. This experience profoundly affected my life, and I've had PTSD since 1971, and as a result, I live in a very tiny and very protected world. Let's fast forward. I know I now have Sunny in my life, and I want to say thanks to PADS and to all the Team Sunny, the raisers, the sitters, the advanced trainers, and as well as a sponsor. I want you to know, at home, Sunny is always by my side in the bathroom, in the shower, in the front room. And at work, while shopping, he's always focused on me and the task at hand. And I once again want to thank all you all for what you've done for me. Thank you.
Congratulations, Team Sunny.
Valor is Cindy's first assistance dog. Cindy is retired and lives on Vancouver Island. She loves to bake, read, or write when at home, or to go out for coffee with a friend. Valor is a lovely yellow Labrador who has a very calm and steady demeanor with a bit of goofiness thrown in. She loves to retrieve and is always keen to help Cindy out. In their free time, Cindy and Valor love getting to spend time with family at the cabin.
I've spent the last 3 months learning to be a team with Valor. She is the quiet, supportive dog that I need to live independently in my little apartment. She is very eager to help me and is very food-oriented. Valor has been helping me with the daily routine of dressing and picking up the many things I drop in a day. She supports me with balancing while I go up and down the stairs. I feel much safer with her at my side. We have traveled to a number of appointments to the hospital and to community activities. We are navigating the many new rules to move through the community safely.
Congratulations, Team Valor!
Daryl and Weber work with Calgary Victim Services alongside PADS AFD Calibri. Weber is a Black Labrador Retriever with a bubbly personality and a gentle, happy demeanor. When he is off the clock, he loves to play hard with his housemate, the now retired PADS Hawk. Hawk tolerates Weber very well. As Daryl's partner, Weber provides support to victims of traumatic events. He supports children and their families as they wait for their turn in court sitting with them during the trial and offering physical and emotional comfort to anyone who needs him.
Weber completed his official team training in early December 2019 with the Calgary Police Service Victim Assistance Support Team. His primary handler is Constable Daryl Jones. In the past year, Weber has responded to in excess of 100 requests for service, totaling several hundred hours. The majority of these events fall within the categories of court support, crisis support, investigative support, school events, and community events. Through these supports, we have gained an excellent working relationship with the Crown Prosecutor's Office, the Calgary Court Center, Calgary and Area Child Advocacy Center, Calgary Communities Against Sexual Abuse, Alberta Health Services, Calgary Sexual Assault Response Team, the Calgary Board of Education, the Calgary Separate School Division, YouthLink, and several other community partners. Weber has also assisted with many CPS forensic interviews while supporting witnesses and victims of crime through this process, up to and including attending court with them. When Weber is not engaged in the above primary activities, he is increasingly being used in the area of peer support to our sworn and civilian members within the Calgary Police Service in conjunction with the CPS Peer Support Team and CPS Psychological Services. Weber has tons of energy, and his tail is in perpetual motion. He is a happy dog that loves being around people and genuinely loves working. Weber, on occasion, is introduced to victims of crime where he must support the victim in the presence of healthcare professionals in environments that the handler cannot be present. An example of this is when Weber is deployed to assist with the Calgary Sexual Assault Response Team. Weber will support the victim up to and including the physical medical examination in the presence of CSART doctor and nurse without his handler present. It is in this environment that Weber excels and receives his greatest praise. The healthcare professionals in this environment are always amazed with how Weber seems to know the right moment to respond to the victim's increased emotional stress. The more the victim becomes anxious, the more Weber moves in closer to provide comfort and support. Weber believes that he is a big lapdog. He thrives in an environment where he can get close to the people he is supporting. I'm very proud of Weber's accomplishments in his first year of service. Thank you, PADS.
Congratulations, Team Weber.
Winnie is Steve's first assistance dog. Steve lives in the Okanagan area. Winnie is a beautiful black Labrador who can be quite the goof. She has a lot of playful energy to go for walks or any other adventures. She also loves to balance all that fun with some cuddles. Steve and Winnie love to go on outings together, including long walks in the neighborhood or running errands. Winnie loves to do her skills and is very enthusiastic and affectionate. She has amazing focus on Steve, both at home and when they are out in public together.
Hello, everyone. We are Team Steve and Winnie, and we got together in August of 2020, and we graduated this fall after having team training online. Winnie and I are really good friends. She helps me a lot through some of the struggles that I experience with my post-traumatic stress. She sleeps with me at night, so if I have nightmares or anything like that, she's there. I can pet her and I can feel her ears to calm me down. And we've really started to bond and connect. We are on an adventure, my wife and I and Winnie and Violet the cat, we're moving to Vancouver Island in the next month or so, but we will still have contact with you folks. And I want to thank all of PAD's sponsors and all of the volunteers and all of the employees for providing me with a companion that helps me live my life to the best. So thank you very much.
Congratulations, Team Winnie.
When Zarya first entered advanced training, she had springs on her hind legs and just got so much joy out of jumping. She also had a powerful nudge with her nose to your pocket or treat pouch if she thought she needed more treats. Zarya is a character. She likes to swim, so one day she jumped off the dock into the lake. And instead of going to shore to get back on the dock, she just stood there with her back paws touching the sand below and her front paws on the deck. What a goofball. Ingrid was matched with service dog Zarya. Together, they love hiking on the trails around Lower Mainland, BC. In her free time, Ingrid loves cooking and doing macrame.
Hi, my name is Ingrid, and my service dog is Zarya. Zarya is an amazing dog with several different sides to her personality. When we are at home, she loves to relax and nap with her zebra faux fur blanket in several places in the home she has claimed as her own. She has recently decided to become a 60-pound lap dog and watch a little TV with me after dinner each night. When she is working and we are doing errands in the stores, she is perfectly composed and extremely focused on me. She makes it very easy for me because of her good behavior and listens to her commands. She does remind me every now and then, with a nose nudge, that she would not object if I gave her a treat. It always makes me smile when I feel her wet nose on my hand when she does this. When Zarya is not at home or working, we go to off-leash trails or to the beach. This is something that I used to do and now am able to do again with the help of Zarya. This is her time to enjoy being a dog. If there is a body of water close by, Zarya will do a jump, run in circles, and then in leaps and bounds run towards the water. She loves the water and loves to swim. Add another large, playful dog and she is in heaven. I've had Zarya for several months now, and she has already had a big impact on my life. We are together 24/7. I had emergency surgery done while I was in training with Zarya, and we were separated for 2 days when I was in the hospital. When I got home, she was so happy to see me, and it was then that I knew that we had bonded. I want to thank all of Zarya's puppy raisers and sitters, her advanced trainers, her sponsors, and the PADS organization. With your help, Zarya has become the dog she is today, and she is a wonderful service dog and companion to me. I will always be extremely grateful and humbled with this gift. Thank you.
Congratulations, Team Ingrid and Zarya.
This spring, Ashley completed all the requirements of her apprenticeship and received certificates as a hearing dog instructor and a service dog instructor. This is a huge accomplishment. It has been a long road with a lot of twists and turns along the way. Ashley was hired in 2015 as an apprentice. Over the time of her apprenticeship, she has successfully trained and placed 21 dogs in the service, hearing, and AFD programs. She has been involved in many aspects of the PADS program: whelping litters, teaching puppy classes, training skills to advanced dogs, reviewing client applications, making matches with clients and dogs, teaching team training, and doing client follow-ups. I sometimes ask the advanced training staff in Burnaby to give me a quote of the week. Most often, Ashley will give a quote from leadership gurus like Tony Robbins or Ray Dalio. Recently, Ashley gave me a different one. For those of you who watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine, you may recognize this quote from Gina Linetti. "The only thing I'm not good at is modesty, because I'm great at it." This quote is very indicative of Ashley's quirky sense of humor, which is one of the qualities that have made it a pleasure to work with her over the past 5 years. Ashley was a great apprentice, and she will be an amazing instructor. She is a very hard worker, diligent, persistent, honest, intelligent, driven, thoughtful, creative, passionate, and generous with her time with dogs, volunteers, staff, and clients. During the COVID-19 pandemic, Ashley developed online team training materials to use with one of our hearing dog clients using a mixture of ASL, closed captioning, and videos. This was a first for PADS. In addition to her regular workload, she also offered to teach online classes to advanced sitters as a pilot project for the Accredited Facility Dog Program. Ashley has been an incredible team member in the advanced training department, and we look forward to her future as an instructor. To celebrate the completion of her apprenticeship, PADS had a visit from some of Ashley's favorite icons: the singer Cher, a Sasquatch, and a unicorn. Congratulations, Ashley.
Not unusual to be loved by anyone. Not unusual to have fun with anyone. Not unusual to go out at any time. When I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever want to be loved by anyone, not unusual.
Congratulating PADS 2020 graduates. And a special thank you to our PADS village of supporters, including volunteers, donors, and staff that helped to ensure these graduates could cross our virtual stage. We celebrate your contributions. It is only with this community effort that we are able to continue to fulfill our mission and place these life-changing assistance dogs. Puma and I are very proud to be part of this remarkable PADS village. Now I'd like to introduce the 2020 Breeding Program graduates. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the scientist behind the genetics of these amazing dogs, Jackie Clark.
Hello, PADS grads and PADS community. My name is Jackie Clark. I'm the breeding program manager at PADS and also a member of the puppy raising team. I'd like to start out on behalf of myself and my colleagues in the breeding program by offering our hearty congratulations to the 2020 graduating class. We're really sorry not to be able to meet you in person at this time, but we are wishing you guys long, happy working partnerships with your assistance dogs, and we look forward to meeting you when the world is a little bit more normal again. It has been a very weird year for the breeding program, as I know it has been for all of you. We started out the year by deciding to pause our breeding program when COVID started to ramp up, because we didn't know what the future held and we needed to get some things in place in order for our puppy raising program to be able to move online and to be able to onboard new volunteers. The result of this was that seven of our girls promptly came into heat and we lost basically half a year's worth of production out of the breeding program. I'm happy to say that we're back on track now. We have six girls who have been bred recently and are hoping to welcome a number of litters before the end of this calendar year. We have experienced some setbacks in terms of transport with the border being closed. A lot of our dogs tend to come in from the US and we tend to export a lot of puppies to the US as well as part of our partnerships with other schools within Assistance Dogs International. So that has also been a little bit of a challenge this year. But nevertheless, we have pushed on. We have had several of our boys serve short-term breeding rotations this year, which is fairly new for us, where a promising young male will sire 1 to 3 litters for the breeding program before being neutered and go back into training. And we have selected 6 lovely new breeding girls to join the breeding department and replace dogs that are retiring this year. Now, one would think when doing breeder selection that we would start by looking at the dogs that we have and deciding who looks the best when we handle them. While the individual dog's personality is really important, we tend to take the approach of gathering a ton of data on all of our dogs ahead of time and shortlisting the dogs that we feel are going to have the most to offer for the breeding program. We look at things like the reports that they've gotten from their puppy instructor and from their puppy raiser. We look at who their sire and dam are and how well they're represented in our breeding program, and whether they're going to bring in some diversity for us, some stability, or whether they're too closely related to the rest of the dogs that we have. And we look at what health problems their sire and dam are known to produce, how their litter mates are doing in training, if they have any temperament problems, if they have any health problems, how their half siblings have done in training or are doing in training. And then also we look at how they perform based on the priorities that we've set for the breeding program. So what traits we're looking to promote and what traits we're looking to try and breed away from. And finally, we combine this all with a final assessment of the dogs that shows us how they perform in different situations when they're under a little bit of stress, as they would be in a working career. To help us refine this process even further in the future, the breeding program is currently involved in a DNA study with the Broad Institute at MIT and Harvard, along with the International Working Dog Breeding Association, where we are hoping to be able to identify specific genes that correspond to temperament traits that we're either trying to promote or to steer away from, as well as different health traits that we are looking to try and manage. And so in the future, we are hoping that we will have even better, more objective information to be able to make breeding decisions based on that. So our first graduate this year is Sierra 2. Sierra is a spicy black lab female. She is from our Tater Tots litter, and she is a fourth generation PADS breeding. And not only that, all four of her grandparents are PADS dogs. Sierra brings beautiful confidence to our program, and we're very excited to have her pass that on to her puppies. Her breeder caretakers are social workers, and so Sierra goes to work with them and has been fitting in really nicely at work. Sierra has had one litter so far, the 7-star hometown crew litter, and is hopefully going to be expecting a second litter later this year. Our second breeding graduate's name is Nala. Nala is a wiggly, social, bright black lab female. She brings in really nice diversity for PADS. She came to us as part of the ABC Breeding Cooperative from Southeastern Guide Dogs down in Florida, and nothing in her pedigree is related to anything else we have. So she opens up a lot of possibilities for us. She has a really beautiful temperament. She is confident, she's stable, and she's good with body handling, all of which we are trying to really promote in the breeding program right now. Our third breeding program graduate's name is Valentine. Valentine was named for a dear PADS volunteer, champion, donor, supporter named Juanita Valentine, who passed away a couple of years ago. Valentine is a yellow lab golden retriever mix. And by mix, I mean that she is mostly Labrador. She has about 4% golden retriever in her. She is from Canine Companions for Independence down in California, and brings in some really nice diversity to our program. She brings in some softness and temperament, but she can also be sweet and feisty. We are hoping that Valentine is going to have a litter at the end of this year. Our fourth breeding program graduate is Heloise. Heloise is a lovely yellow lab female. She is a homegrown PADS pup. She was born here, and she is the third generation of our breeding. She is from our Philosopher's litter. Heloise can be sweet and cuddly at home. In puppy class, she was described as a dog who had learned to fake calm but was always ready to go. She is a new mum. She has a litter of puppies on the ground right now named the Ballet Legends litter, and she really loves her puppies and loves being a mum. Our fifth breeding program graduate is Posey. Posey is a sweet little black lab female. Posey came to us as a stud fee from Southeastern Guide Dogs. And what that means is when another school uses one of our stud dogs, in exchange, we get the pick female puppy from the litter back. So it's a nice way that's kind of underappreciated for PADS to bring in new lines and supplement our number of puppies through other schools using our stud dogs. Posey brings in some really nice diversity through her dam line, which is not related to anything that we have. She is a calmer, more low-key, even-keeled dog, which we need a little bit of to balance with our spicier dogs, and also to produce some of our really nice accredited facility dog type temperaments. Heloise and Posey were both raised in schools, and Posey, one of her good traits is that she is really good with body handling, which is something that some of our dogs struggle with. So we're really trying to promote bringing that into our program. Our last breeding program graduate is Jewel. Jewel is also a lab golden retriever mix who is very heavily on the lab side. She is a wiggly little girl. She comes from Canine Companions for Independence in California as well, and brings in some really great diversity for our program. She isn't related to anything else, which gives us all sorts of options in terms of who we want to breed her to. One of Jewel's greatest qualities is that she brings in really great resilience. If anything happens that causes her to get a little bit excited or anxious, she transitions right back into working mode really easily. Jewel also has really great hearing dog traits. When we tested her, if the smoke alarm went off, her inclination was to listen to it, go back to her handler and move back towards the sound, which is something that we look for. And so we hope that she will pass that on to some of her puppies as well. So there you have it. Those are the six girls who are graduating in the breeding program this year. Hopefully by next year's grad, they will all have had litters born into the PADS program, and we will see those puppies in the puppy parade next year. Thank you guys all for your ongoing support. Congratulations again to our clients, and I hope that next year we will be able to see one another in person.
Thank you, Jackie, and warmest congratulations to our breeding graduates. I would like to now introduce our fearless leader, our executive director, Laura Wadamanik.
Welcome to this first virtual and most amazing occasion. We are gathered here through the marvels of technology to celebrate and honor our 2020 graduating class and the work of our village this past year. And what a year it has been. I know I say that every year, but well, quite simply, 2020 takes the cake. Literally, friends, usually we'd be wrapping up our ceremony, trying to dull the pads cold, then enjoying a delicious piece of graduation cake. How on earth can I capture this year in just a few words and photographs? As they say where I'm from, it's a hard row to hoe. And yes, I made the staff put that up on the screen today. And like a hard row to hoe, it's been full of rocks and roots and sweats and tears, tears of grief, tears of frustration with worries on how we were gonna make it all through this, tears of joy when we succeeded. And today we gather to celebrate the year of hard work and the countless efforts of so many. So what a better way to tell a story than through pictures? We've Zoomed, we've Skyped, we've FaceTimed, and we've texted. We've battled with gremlins and glitches and gizmos. We've tackled technology and had a few tantrums. We've placed precious puppies by drive-through and by distance. We've canceled it all and we put it online. Okay, I agree, I am not a Dr. Seuss. So instead, I just want to take the time to thank each and every one of you for how you have persevered. When our gala was canceled and taken online, you showed up. The inaugural move event was supposed to be an in-person walk to raise $50,000. And in spite of this year's challenges, it became better, more accessible, more inclusive, and it raised a remarkable $100,000. You showed up. When our calendar sales opened, you pre-ordered like never before and showed up. When a volunteer needed a break, you showed up. When our staff needed help, you showed up. When we set a day to celebrate, you show up. Look at everyone watching this from all over the globe. All of our friends are gathered here today to help us celebrate. Team PADS kept going. Many of our colleagues across the industry had to shut down all breeding and puppy raising programs. They suspended placements and laid off some of their staff. Some programs are still closed. And while this fills me with grief for them, it reminds me daily why I'm so incredibly proud of this team. PADS slowed down, but we never stopped. The team kept each other and our volunteers safe, but found ways to continue to do the work, to place the dogs, as you've seen with these amazing teams today. Usually we'd have just one valedictorian, but this year we opted instead to extend this honor to every single team by way of our weekly Tune In Tuesday series because, as Margaret said, they've earned it. They have faced this year with grace, humor, and perseverance. Thank you, Stormy and Bright, for kicking this off with our It Takes a Village series. There are many, many more stories to come, peppered in with puppies, of course. Not only will you be able to hear their journey and how their dogs have impacted their lives, you will also be able to ask them questions. This year has brought many challenges along with the losses. Sadly, we say goodbye to some of our dear people and our beloved dogs. It's been also painful to say goodbye to some of our staff this year and have others that are still on reduced work hours. But we've also witnessed the ferocious spirit of this organization. Our volunteers, there is nothing that they won't do, and with such grace and patience. They have stepped up to help in so many ways, putting their whole hearts into each and every task. Our donors, how you have come through this year. Financially, COVID has hit us all very hard, but time and time again, you have stepped up and exceeded our expectations with your generosity and passion. Our board, well, this team has stood alongside us this year, faithfully supporting and regrouping as necessary. Our ambitious strategic plans for 2020, well, they were not canceled, but definitely we had to put them on hold for some months as we allowed our management team to roll with the dozens of punches that came our way. We thank the board for their unfailing support and assistance and look forward to implementing these plans in the months and the years to come. Our staff, well, they have been the rock and our glue and even silly putty sometimes. They do whatever is needed. This job has never been 9 to 5, but COVID, well, not just COVID. This year we shall remember as 2020. It has thrown so much at them and they're still standing. Weary to be sure, but a team that loves PADS and loves what we do, and they will stop at nothing to get the job done. I am simply so very honored and proud to work with each of them. Our clients, you are our ambassadors. You are the reason we exist. Thank you for this year, for your dedication to these amazing dogs, your words of support and encouragement, the remarkable efforts of PADS superstars during the move event. We thank you all. So whoever and however you fit in this organization, please join me in recognizing Team PADS and whatever role you play, I thank you. All of this brings me to today. Today we celebrate and honor the graduating teams of 2020, many of whom have patiently waited for the perfect match. The entire PADS Village welcomes you, supports you, and wishes you success with your new PADS partner. You are now officially part of this family. Be prepared to be loved. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Laura, and another congratulations to all of our 2020 graduates. We would also like to congratulate the recipients of our 2020 VIP dogs, and we could not successfully place these dogs without our VIP committee. They help us find the best homes, make the best matches for these very important pets. We would like to thank our village of volunteers, the breeder caretakers, puppy raisers and sitters, our advanced sitters, kennel and office and facility volunteers, and all of the integral committees that support the work of our PADS staff and our programs. Each of you play a critical role to PADS success. Our PADS program is operated out of 4 regions, PADS Vancouver, Vancouver Island, Okanagan, and Calgary. It takes a whole community to raise one assistance dog, and we have a dedicated and amazing village. Many of you may have seen our 2020 puppy parade that was published to our social media on Friday, but if you missed it, we're going to close with it again. This extraordinary village of volunteers has continued to raise these life-changing puppies by Zoom and pure grit. Join me in thanking them for their persistence, patience, and passion. That is it for me and Miss Pumalu. Thank you once again for joining us for the 2020 PADS graduation. I look forward to seeing you all next year.